Hi, friends. Thank you so much for tuning in to our last episode of At Intermission for a While. It has been so brilliant hanging out with you guys every Tuesday and meeting some new community partners and playwrights and designers and artists in the area. It has been so much fun, and the support and love that each of you have given in viewing and donating, it has been absolutely overwhelming for us. So please continue to watch our Facebook and make sure that you subscribe to our emails so we can continue to get great information out for you. So we'll be back. Don't forget that at the end of the month, we are still doing Divas. That's going to be a brilliant performance, and we cannot wait to get rehearsals started. We hope that you guys are staying safe out there. We hope to see you again very, very soon. But until that time comes, please stay well. Please wear your mask. And I hope that you have a wonderful 4th of July weekend. Everybody, hello. Thank you for joining me for the last At Intermission episode for a while. We are going to start phasing this out because Center Stage has opened back up. We are doing a lot more things. So, oh man, we're just trying to phase out a little bit. So, small staff doing a lot of things. At Intermission will not be going away indefinitely, just for a brief time as we continue to figure out what live theater is like in the era of COVID. So for my last episode, I wanted to bring on one of my dear, dear friends, Ahsha Daniels. Everybody say hello. Ahsha, say hello.
Hey, what's up?
Ahsha and I have been friends, I think we figured out, it was like 5 or 6 years. Wait, no, 2013, yeah. So like 7, because it's 2020. Yes. Yeah, so 7 years.
We have been crazy. Friends.
Yes, I met Ahsha when I was little baby Jess and just moved on to the scene in Greenville, South Carolina. And Ahsha directed my very first new play festival reading at Center Stage, which was like my first professional show. And she like was so intense, and she walked into the room and she was like, hired, fired. And it was so much fun. And the rest is history. We've been friends ever since.
Yes, you're my girl.
Yeah. And you introduced me to like so much. I remember, so I had all the friends in Spartanburg because that was where you hung out with the Spartanburg. So like, I made all of
these always go hang out all the way in Spartanburg because I didn't really know people in Greenville. Yes.
And I lived in Easley, so I would be driving to Spartanburg to hang out and then all the way back to Easley. It was insane. Oh my gosh.
Yes, downtown Spartanburg.
We were young and we had all the energy. So that's what it is. Yes. So y'all, Ahsha she's a pretty big deal in Greenville. So if you have not had the pleasure to meet her, definitely do so. Ahsha has been, you've been directing really since you graduated college at USC Upstate. So you kind of been like consistently in the game and just learning and growing. And then you moved to Atlanta for a while, which was very sad, Greenville. But you moved so there to do an apprenticeship with Horizon Theater.
Yeah, Horizon Theater Company.
Yeah, so tell us a little bit about your experience with Horizon.
So it was an acting apprenticeship, and it was for 10 months. And there were a lot, they had an acting apprenticeship, then they had stage management, directing, and playwriting. So we were all like in a class together or whatever. So it was 10 months. And at the end of that 10 months, you go to Unifieds. And after Unifieds, it's just, you kind of graduate and then they send you off into the world and you're on your own. And so it was a great opportunity. It was great networking. You learned a lot of people. You saw amazing shows for free. And so, but it was just like a great opportunity to learn the business a little bit more. But it was really, it was a hard 10 months. And I think it was also because I was like, oh, this is a new city. And I had like started the apprenticeship right when I got there. So that was intense, and Atlanta is intense. Yeah. And so, so it was a little bit like nerve wracking, but a great experience after I got out of it and looked back on it. And so I went, and it was an acting apprenticeship, but I probably got one acting role, a role for a show. And then the rest of the jobs that I did in Atlanta were directing, which is awesome. But, you know, I know acting was my first love. And I think that was really what got me in, you know, really got me into theater, which, you know, I'm all about doing whatever I can, but I would love to just be back on stage. I would have loved to be on stage more in Atlanta. That would have been the best.
Well, so you did your directing gigs in Atlanta. And I know that you've worked with a lot of youth theaters you have here in the Greenville area and in Atlanta. So that's yeah. Like, is that something you ever thought you would be doing a lot of?
Nope.
But, you know, I
don't even know how it happened. I think I started, like, I think I taught a class at Spartanburg Youth Theater.
Yeah.
Like, probably 10 years, I don't know how many years, probably like 10 years ago. And I just kind of did it because they needed it, needed somebody at the last minute, and it was like, 7-year-old, so I was like, okay, I'll do it, you know. And I was like, I'll just go and play a bunch of games with them, it'll be fine, you know. And I went, and I had more fun than those kids had. So I just never looked back after that. Like, I will pick kids over adults every day.
Y'all, and I can say, like, Ahsha is so brilliant when it comes not only directing, but when it comes to directing youth theater, Ahsha does such a good job, because I have gone to see her youth theater productions, The Weird Adult That Doesn't Know Anybody. But Ahsha will take so much pride in the work, and she gets to know these kids, and they love her, and she loves them, and you can tell they are having the best time on stage. So, listen. Yeah. South Carolina Children's Theater, Spartanburg Youth. I know you're already working there, but Ahsha knows her way around some children's theater and youth theater. She's pretty.
Yes, excellent. I'm trying to get in the South Carolina Children's Theater for real.
Listen, man, my first theater I ever worked at in Greenville, and I had so much fun. I was a part of their tour, and I have done everything to try to get back there, of course, but, you know, life gets in the way, and in the world of theater.
I feel like I remember that. What was it?
Once Upon a Wolf. It was so good.
Yep. Like, I remember that.
Up or something like that, but it was so much fun. We had a blast with that production, and I got to meet Miss Betsy Besson, who's absolutely brilliant, and I've been trying to get back there ever since, and it's just like 1 year in the world of theater I feel is like 3 years in real time. Yeah. So I'm still just working to get back there, but I have friends who work there and absolutely love it. So I'm definitely excited to see what their new space has in store, for sure.
Oh my God. Every time beautiful. I drive by, I'm like, oh my
God.
It's
so gorgeous. It's so gorgeous. Yeah, it's so beautiful. Just so you know, Ahsha has what it takes, people. So you theater. You have been back in the area for like a little over a year now. But you're still doing some pretty epic things. You're still directing with Spartanburg Youth Theater, and now you're actually a member of Spartanburg Little Theater's board just pretty recently, right? Congratulations.
Yes. I had my first board meeting, like, it was a couple weeks ago, and I was really hoping somebody was going to be like, hey, you busy on Tuesday? So I could be like, yes, I am. I got a board meeting. I'm on the board.
In addition to directing with the youth theater at Spartanburg, you've also directed on their main stage.
For Spartanburg Little Theater, yeah.
Yes, and it was Terms of Endearment, and it was just this past year, right?
It was their last show. It was like the last weekend of Terms, or Terms of Endearment, was right when things started shutting down for COVID. And so I remember that last weekend, we didn't know if they were going to let us finish the shows. Wow. Like, after the, you know how after the show, the actors will go out in the audience or go out in the lobby. We didn't do that the whole second weekend. So I was really nervous, but we finished, we closed, and we did all the shows. So it was awesome.
I saw that production and it was so beautiful. I loved everything about it. Like, you did such a good job with that show. And I'm not saying that because she's my friend. Like, it was a really beautiful production of that show. I thought everybody did an amazing job with it. Now that you're back in Greenville, because I know you've been working out in Atlanta for a while and you really just wanted to hone in more on directing and things like that. And so now that you're back in the area, do you have any specific goals as far as what you'd like to achieve as a director here? Are there any like particular theaters you want to work at? Is there any specific shows? Or are you just really trying to grind and just really continue to hone your craft as a director?
I would definitely say I'm just trying to grind. I am open to really anything, you know, because it's only going to help me. I know that, you know, and so, but yes, I would love to work at Warehouse. And
let me just tag Mike Sablode real quick.
Like us. But yeah, like I would love to just work, you know. Like one of my goals for my career was to get to a point where I was working pretty consistently, and not like struggling to pay my bills and stuff like that.
Right.
And do what I love to do, you know, and, you know, just be living the life. And like COVID,
right.
But, you know, for a while I was like very content with like working pretty consistently and still being challenged and that sort of thing. And so, I would just like to stay here in Greenville for a while and just continue to introduce myself to other theaters and get other experiences, working with different people, and get introduced to people, because I've seen so many like actors of color that I never knew, and I never, like when I was here 7 years ago, you know, we probably just missed each other. But I'm like, I'm so excited about this community that I either didn't know about or is new. You know, I want to be in it. I'm trying to dive in it.
Right.
You know, so same. I'm just like excited to meet people and work with new artists and stuff.
Same. I'm very excited. You know, you and I have definitely talked about this in detail. I'm very excited to see the direction that Greenville might be heading, with, you know, just the attention that has been brought upon actors of color or musicians of color, directors of color, music directors of color. So I am really, really excited to see the direction that we're going. You know, you have to, it's so funny because when you and I talk, we can talk pretty candidly, but you really do have to choose your words carefully in order to make sure that you're getting across the right message. And I think that message for people of color is that we're here, we love this, and we're so excited to be a part of this culture for more than just shows that are made for people of color. Because, listen, I'm trying to play Elle Woods. You know what I'm saying? I can be legally blonde as well.
I'm trying to play I'm trying to have a white husband.
Right.
And my kids run around. Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
I probably couldn't play Elwood's though. I'm just saying. That's a lot. With all of the talks, I know you and I have been a part of some talks. And just been on panels for things. And I know that you have a panel that's coming up as well. So I'm really excited to see the direction that Greenville is taking as far as just talking about this. And
yeah,
knowing, you know, I feel like it's really important for people to watch this at intermission episode, because maybe a lot of people don't know that you're a director because you have acted on stage before, and maybe they think, oh, Ahsha just likes to do stage work, but no, you're actually a very well-seasoned director at this stage in the game. So it's definitely time for, one, people to be selecting more directors of color. It is time. It is time. And Ahsha Daniels is pretty brilliant at it, not just because she's my friend. She has a degree in this and some training and experience in the professional world. And three, there are plenty of shows that are out there for directors of color, and there is a voice. There's a voice that needs to be heard from directors of color, and we have those people in Greenville. So it's definitely a fun change that is about to come about, and I'm really excited about it. And I think it's really cool that you're here and I'm here, and we've met all of these people that we didn't know. So
yes, that's amazing. But I think that I want to say, like, the main thing is, like, I'll be excited when we get to a point where I'm in the director pool, period. You know, like, you need 5 directors for your season, for your 5 shows for your season. I already want to be in that pile, not because, oh, we need, okay, who do we have that's a Black girl, or who do we have Black that can direct? You know what I mean? Just go ahead and put me in there because I'm a director, you know?
Correct.
100%. And the same thing, like, with the acting, like, we don't just put a Black show in your season to give us a chance, you know what I mean? Like, you're not quite getting it if that's where, you know, if that's all you're doing, you know. And so so I just want it to be at a point where, like, at the end of the day, you have a story to tell. There's a story to tell. And so if I walk in there and I have told this story the best, then I want you to put me as that lead. And don't be afraid that, oh, well, the other lead that we have is a white guy. People aren't going to believe. The audience is not going to be okay with. They're going to be really upset. I'm going to get a lot of emails.
Yeah.
So what? Respond to those emails. You know what I mean? Put me in that show. Cast me in that show. And respond to those emails. You know, like, that's, I want to get to a point where we are there and not so afraid, you know.
You and I had spoke the other day about Proof, the play Proof. And you had said in Atlanta, you had seen an all Black version of Proof.
Yes.
And how it was so amazing, and it was actually elevated because you were looking at the life of
Black mathematician.
Yes. And so, you know, it makes
me, I just get chills when I think about it. Oh my goodness.
It makes me really excited and I hope that my friends of color who are auditioning in this community realize that it's very important for us as actors of color and actresses of color to audition for shows that we don't think are necessarily geared for us. Even if you come out and it's not, you don't see many of you in the room, it's still important for you to be there. One, because auditioning is important for the working professional actor, which you and
that is your job. Mm-hmm. Your job. Uh-oh. As an actor is to audition. I mean, that's just, your job is to audition. When you get the role, that's vacation.
Yes.
But your job, your job is to audition. You gotta show up.
Exactly. So, you know, it's important for us to be at auditions for Legally Blonde, auditions for Bonnie and Clyde, auditions, you know, Aida is predominantly, well, actually, no, even though Aida was not cast as an all-Black cast on Broadway, I mean, it should be. You're looking at Nubians, you know, so even if you don't think that this show is meant for
for people of color, audition anyway, because girl, you need the practice. So what else better you got to do than sit at home and not go out and audition for the show and at least have somebody see you? So that way, when we do cast shows in the future, who knows? They could be like, I saw a girl and she wasn't right for X, Y, and Z, but she is right for this role.
Yeah. Remember that girl we saw that one time?
Yeah.
Like, one thing I learned, one of my mentors in Atlanta said, find a reason to be in the room. Mm. And I like that has stuck with me because I think I've missed out on so many opportunities because I thought I already knew. Right. You know, like, oh, so-and-so's going to be at that audition. She's going to get it, you know, or I would, and I either wouldn't show up or I'd show up and not really show up, you know, and, or I thought like, I just already assumed that I knew what the director wanted or whatever. And so I missed out by not showing up, I missed out on the opportunity to possibly prove them wrong.
Right.
You know what I mean? And possibly really get that Elle Woods role.
Right.
You know, because who knows? You don't know if the director is against that kind, you know, or is scared of that kind of thing, you know, like you just never know. So you have to just always show up, always be there. Even if you don't, if you know there's no role for you, do they need help taking headshots? Because you need to be that person, you know, because I would remember, I think now being on the directing side more and the casting side more, I remember those people that are always right there like, hey, you good? Hey, you need this? Hey, you need that? They may be real annoying, but I'm going to remember. Like, I'm good, girl, back up. But I'm going to remember them, you know, when I do need a stage manager or when I do, when I am like, she wasn't right for that one role, but she would kill this one role.
Right.
So you just got to always be in the room, find a reason, whatever the reason is, be in there.
I mean, Ahsha, you've been doing this for a while, and I know that you kind of see the long game aspect of everything, but I see a little bit more since I'm just showing up to the shows that you're directing, you know, so I definitely get a different perspective than you do, and you're doing a lot of great work here, and I think that you're putting yourself in the right positions to continue to excel in Greenville, and I'm really excited to see where we go and all of that.
Thank you, girl.
Yeah, all day, every day.
Thank you, boo.
But that's really all I got. I mean, y'all, we've got a working professional director and actress here in the Greenville Upstate, and she is doing some amazing things. And we're excited. I'm excited that Asha's here. You should also be excited that Asha's here.
I'm excited.
Yes.
I'm excited that I'm here.
Yes.
Be excited that I'm here.
Is there anything else you want to share with us, man? Do you have anything coming up in the future, maybe?
Well, we don't see, because I mean, I don't know about this corona.
Yes.
Shoot. Yes. And she's trying to come back.
Yeah.
Well, it's because people ain't wearing their masks.
And she's back. She is back. She is back.
Depends on the, you know, kind of like what Corona does, you know, what theaters are allowed to do.
Okay.
But if we are back up and running like semi-normal, then I will direct Spartanburg Youth Theater's holiday show.
Oh, nice.
So that's all I have coming up for 2020. The rest is TBD.
heard that.
but that's it. I'm so excited. I just really am excited to be back and to really just be working consistently and working with all these different artists and artists that I knew from back when I was here before and then new artists that are here now. I'm just excited to just be back home, you know.
Right.
With my girl Jess. So I'm back,
man, and I couldn't be more excited, and I'm super thrilled to see what the year 2020 has for the rest of us. It looks like 2021 may be a little bit better of a year, but it's still really exciting to see the direction that
2021 I'm gonna be living my best life. I think everybody went into 2020 like, oh, 2020 vision. I got a new vision on life.
Right.
And So we're going to try again. 2021. I got a new vision on life.
So, yay, y'all, I have Ahsha's contact information. If you would like it, please reach out. Or she is on Facebook.
Can we put it like in a link below?
I'll do my best. I've been learning a lot about editing. So this is a new
You did good, girl. I watched all the rest of the videos and I'm like, okay.
You can just like,
on your resume.
You can see the progression from episode one to now. This
yes.
one all the bells.
I'm excited whistles. About watching mine.
Just so you know, Ahsha and I definitely took Wine with Jess serious today. We both had our favorite drinks. We're going out with a bang, and we wanted to really have a good time and laugh and hang out with y'all and just really talk about some fun stuff for this last episode. So we will miss you at Intermission, viewers, and thank y'all for tuning in to Wine with Jess with Jesse Eckenrod Cherry. I've had a brilliant time being here and hanging out with you guys. Thank you again, Ahsha, for being on the show, and hopefully we will see you guys on the stage one day soon. Wear your mask, stay safe, and be well. Do you have any vocal impressions you can do?
No.
Okay. Okay. I won't add any of that in. I guess we'll have a singer on this one either.
I'm so glad you didn't ask me that, because I would have had that exact same answer. No. Next question.